أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين، واللعنة الدائمة على أعدائهم أجمعين إلى قيام يوم الدين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Who was Muslim ibn Awsaja? Muslim ibn Awsaja, may Allah bless him, may Allah be pleased with him, was one of the giants in history. Unfortunately, we do not have much information about his life, but he was one of the main companions of Imam al-Husayn and the main martyrs in Karbala. Peace be upon them all. Muslim was a companion of Rasulullah Muhammad himself, peace be upon him and his family, and narrated some of his narrations. This shows us that some of the companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him and his family, were truly devoted to the Prophet and to the Ahlul Bayt. They had true love for Rasulullah and for Ahlul Bayt, peace be upon them. And they understood that they had to support Ahlul Bayt in general and Imam al-Husayn, peace be upon him, specifically. Rasulullah had made it clear to the Muslim Ummah, to the Muslim nation, that Imam al-Husayn, peace be upon him, will be martyred in Karbala, and that he will be oppressed, and that it will be the duty of all the Muslims in that era to support Imam al-Husayn, peace be upon him. We realize that Muslim ibn Awsaja, being one of the companions of Rasulullah, understood the words of the Prophet, and he gave those words value and went to Karbala in order to obey Rasulullah, support Imam al-Husayn, and fall as a martyr in front of his Imam Husayn, son of Ali. So he was one of the companions of the Prophet. He narrated certain narrations about or from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was an individual that was an old man. His age was very old in Karbala. We realize that he wasn't the only companion of Imam al-Husayn who was old. For example, there's one companion of Rasulullah himself called Anas, who was present in Karbala and martyred in Karbala. Anas was in his 90s. He was so old that his eyebrows would fall down on his eyes. And so when he wanted to fight on the day of Ashura, he had to put some sort of cloth and wrap it on his forehead in a way that he raises his eyebrows so that he can see. You have Habib bin Mudahir, who was in his 70s, Anas, who was in his 90s, Jaun, who was in his 80s. Now the question is, what made Muslim ibn Awsaja and his likes, these old men, what made them fight like warriors in Karbala? What made them so strong and so brave? The answer is, they understood that Imam al-Husayn was an infallible Imam, appointed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they fell in complete love with Imam al-Husayn salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. We can accomplish great goals through our belief and our love in Imam al-Husayn, in our love for Imam al-Husayn salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, just as companions like Muslim ibn Awsaja and Habib ibn Mudahir were able to fight like warriors in the battlefield out of their love and their passion for Husayn ibn Ali salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. Muslim ibn Awsaja as well had been given the task by Muslim ibn Aqil in Kufa to lead two tribes, the tribe of Asad and the tribe of Mudhaj, when Muslim wanted to wage an attack against the enemies of Islam in Kufa. Muslim ibn Awsaja himself used to request from the people, he used to demand them to pledge allegiance for Imam al-Husayn salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, and he himself was living in Kufa, which tells us that not all the people in Kufa were against Imam al-Husayn salawatullahi alayhi. In fact, Several people from Kufa were martyred in Karbala on the side of Imam al-Hussein, alayhi salat wa salam. Thus, not everyone in Kufa was against the Ahlul Bayt. In fact, those who were against the Ahlul Bayt in Kufa and participated and killed Imam al-Hussein in Karbala, those people were not from the followers of Imam al-Hussein or the Ahlul Bayt. Peace be upon them all. Muslim was an Arab. He was from the northern Arabs. And I say this so that we can understand that the companions of Imam al-Hussein came from different backgrounds. You'll see someone who is Arabic in Karbala. You'll see some of the martyrs are from Turkey. For example, al-Ghulam al-Turki, the Turkish slave. Some of them were white, others were black. Some were slaves, others were free men. What does this tell you? It tells you that your background, your skin color, your social status does not determine who you are. What determines who you truly are is, number one, your belief, that your belief in Allah, in Rasulullah, in Ahlul Bayt, in the Day of Judgment, and your actions. The belief of the companions of Hussein and their actions made them Ansar al-Hussein, the supporters of Abi Abdullah, peace be upon him. Muslim ibn Awsaja had incredible, unbelievable passion for Imam al-Hussein, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, to the extent you realize that once he fell on the plains of Karbala, his only worry was supporting Imam al-Hussein himself, peace be upon him. The narration tells us that on the day of Ashura, Muslim ibn Awsaja attacked the enemy. He attacked Amr ibn al-Hajjaj and his companions. The dust rose, and once the dust settled, Muslim was seen lying on the plains of Karbala. But he had a little bit of life in him. He was breathing his last breath. And so Imam al-Hussein and Habib bin Mudahir, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon them both, they came towards Muslim ibn Awsaja. Imam al-Hussein addressed him saying, Rahimakallah ya Muslim. Rahimakallah ya Muslim. May Allah bless you, Muslim. Then he recited the verse, فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظَرْ وَمَا بَدَّلُهُ تَبْدِيلًا. So of them is he who accomplished his vow, and of them is he who awaits, and they have not changed the least. Habib bin Mudahir, who was a relative of Muslim bin Awsaja, came close to him. He said, may Allah bless you, O Muslim. Azza alayya masra'uk. It is dear for me to see you in your estate. Glad tidings, O Muslim, you will be going into heaven. At that moment, Muslim replied to Habib saying, Basharakallah bi khayr. May Allah bring you glad tidings. Habib replied saying, Muslim, if I did not know that I will be following your footsteps, meaning that I will be a martyr after a few minutes, then I would have told you to utter your will. Muslim told him at that point in a faint voice as he was pointing towards Imam al-Hussein, salawatullahi alayhi, أوصيك بهذا الغريب. My will, O Habib, is that you fight and defend this man, defend the stranger, pointing to Imam al-Hussein. Fight and defend him until your last breath. Habib replied, he said to him, I swear by the Lord of the Kaaba that I will do so. The poet comes forward and says, as if Muslim bin Awsaja is addressing Habib, saying, O Habib, my death has drawn near.
قربات قربات يا بن ظاهر منيتي او ابن مظاهر او حبيب my death has drawn near ان شاء انيتك مثيل نيتي حبيب if you have an intention like mine then I want you to listen to my will ما اوصيك بعيالي وبيتي my will isn't that you take care of my family then what is your will oh Muslim بالحسين وأهله وصيتي My will is that you take good care of Imam al-Hussein and his family members ولبن حسين وأهله وصيتي
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون May Allah bless the soul of Muslim ibn Awsajah and the souls of all companions who defended Imam al-Hussein, peace be upon him. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.